Welcome to Healthcare Workflow Process Improvement, Process Change, Implementation, and Evaluation. This is Lecture A. Objectives for this lecture are to develop a process change implementation plan for a healthcare facility that includes tasks to be accomplished, responsible parties for various tasks, a timeline, and the human and material resources needed. Identify management tracking and measurement opportunities for the process change. Outline elements of an evaluation plan that will help determine the success of a workflow process change implemented in a healthcare facility. And describe how the workflow analyst can help a healthcare facility continually improve its workflow processes based on results of ongoing evaluations. The topics covered in this lecture include common process changes, implementation plan components, communication for implementation, common implementation problems, and evaluating the new process. To ground ourselves in concrete ideas of what to expect in process change implementation and in this unit, we'll start with examples of common process changes. Some examples are from manual to electronic prescribing, from receptionist to web-based appointment scheduling, from manual to automated appointment reminder calls, from manual tracking of test results to automated result tracking, from paper to electronic patient charts, from paper to electronic test ordering. While each of these is just a sentence, changes must be considered and thought through from many perspectives and eventualities. This thinking occurs in the analysis and redesign phase, as each of these eventualities may represent different process design options. For example, different workflows, different allocation of tasks, etc. The implementation planning stage of a project is for figuring out how the implementation, also called go-live or rollout, will occur. Implementation planning is a group activity that includes multiple stakeholders. Communication of the implementation plan and execution resulting in new improved process will also involve many people. The implementation plan documents the who, what, where, when, how, and why of the process change. It serves as a map that helps the clinic staff, leadership, and analyst get from the old process to the new one. An implementation plan contains the following components: reason for the process change, summary of what will be different with reference to the as-is and to-be documentation, where it is located in the documents or in an appendix. Where the process change is significant, this may include step-by-step instructions for new workflows. Sequence of implementation tasks to be accomplished. These can include walkthroughs, training, production and distribution of job aids, software changes, or go-live of new systems. Responsible parties for each implementation task. An implementation schedule for the entire implementation phase and statement of how the process will be managed. Contact information for who to call when problems arise. And a description of how the process change will be evaluated. An evaluation plan. An implementation plan does not need to be a long document. Its purpose is to document what will happen, how and when it will happen, in a way such that if the implementation plan is followed, the new process will become a reality. The length and detail level should be comparable to the size of the change and the number of people impacted. An example implementation plan that shows these components is included in your course materials and will be reviewed on the next few slides. But first, we will do an exercise. You already know enough to draft an implementation plan for an appointment reminder system. After these instructions, pause the slides and do the exercise. A practice of 50 staff and providers is implementing an automated appointment reminder system. Review the implementation plan components on the previous slide. You may want to go back and print out the slide. Take 10 to 15 minutes and on one page of paper, jot down your ideas for each section. Restart the slides when you are done. Pause the slides now. An example reason for the change statement for an implementation plan for automated appointment reminders might be: in efforts to decrease our no-show rate, Big City Medical Practice is implementing automated appointment reminder calls. Due to a lack of staff, our practice has not commonly made appointment reminder calls. With our new system, we are now able to do this. An example of a statement for what will be different is, "What will be different?" Our patients are not used to receiving reminder calls. Starting in 2 weeks, Friday, October 29th, 2011, each patient that schedules an appointment will receive notice that they will receive a reminder call. This notice will be generated automatically for appointments scheduled online. For appointments made over the phone or in person, front desk staff scheduling the patient will inform them. Patients with appointments that were scheduled prior to Monday, October 30th, 2011, will not receive reminder calls. We are informing everyone in the practice with patient contact of this new practice, in case patients have questions or comments about their reminder call. For more information, process diagrams and documentation describing details of this change are available in the break room. Other than notifying patients of this change and being alert for patient questions or comments, there are no significant changes to anyone's workflow. An example time schedule and responsibilities for implementation of an automated appointment system is shown here. An example of the management statement includes who will actually be responsible for the implementation management. For instance, the implementation will be managed by C. Doe from our local regional extension center with support from Amy Smith, our local IT technical support person. Changes to the schedule above will be posted in the break room. An example of the What to Do When Problems Arise section for implementation of an automated appointment reminder system might include wording such as the following. For any unexpected problems, and if you notice or patients mention unusual system behavior, please contact Amy Smith at 555-555-5555 or C. Doe at 777-777-7777. If problems occur after hours, report through the after hours number at 888-888-8888. An example of the evaluation description for implementation of an automated appointment reminder system might include, this process change will be evaluated by the decrease in no-show visits and by addition of a question to the December patient satisfaction survey. At the point in a process redesign when an analyst is crafting an implementation plan, hopefully the impacted people will already know about the change or have otherwise been involved in creating the change in some way. In this case, the communication about the implementation will be easy and expected by all. If not, expect objections either to the plan or the new process or both. In this event, the communication and implementation will take longer and may result in changes to the process or plan. The way to prevent such a situation is to, at a minimum, keep everyone informed about a process change throughout the analysis and redesign process. The more transparency there is, and even better, the more genuine involvement people have opportunity for, the smoother the implementation will be. Remember our old adage from Unit 9. Tell me, and I'll forget. Show me, and I may remember. Involve me, and I'll understand. When communicating an implementation plan, it is important to keep in mind what things people need to know. As in the automated appointment reminder system implementation plan example, when the change is minor, the plan itself can be short and can double as a notice, i.e., the communication. The main goal is to give people information about what is happening. Why is the change taking place? Examples of this might include to enable patient self-management or control, to increase safety, quality, or efficiency of care, for sustainability of the practice, or to achieve meaningful use. How they will be affected. This is often best accomplished by addressing each task or activity that will be added, changed, or go away. How the change will impact their job workflow or responsibilities. How the change will take place. And what, if anything, different will the patient see? Communication can occur via email, posted notices, or staff meetings. In person, communication provides opportunities for attendees to ask questions, and for the presenter to get feedback that might increase the success of the project. When process changes necessitate new steps or tasks, job aids may be helpful. For example, in the automated appointment reminder system implementation, the front desk receptionist needed to notify people scheduling appointments that they would be receiving a reminder call. A job aid with talking points, answers to common questions the receptionist might be asked, was provided as a job aid. Job aids might include talking points, checklists, written procedures, or cheat sheets, memory aids to rescue people when they forget what to do, or descriptions of new system features for common tasks. The type and extent of the job aid depend on how extensive the change is. The creation and training on job aids should be included in the implementation plan. When process changes require new skills, like using new software, a different way of doing something, like completing a lab sample requisition form on the computer versus a paper one, training should occur. Training should also occur when multiple ways of doing something are possible, but the job requires that everyone does it the same way. The formality of the training depends on the extensiveness of the change and the number of people that need to be trained, and can include classroom-style training, one-on-one training, or web-based modules for software training. Time for development or procurement of training should be included in the implementation plan, as should time for the training to occur. An implementation plan does not stand alone. After all of the planning and communication have occurred, it is time for execution, i.e., to execute the plan and to make the new process a reality. Most importantly, unexpected things will occur in even the best planned and managed implementations. In addition to technical and training software support staff, the person in charge of the implementation needs to be present, visible, and available the first few days of a new process to help resolve any problems that occur. It is never fun when problems do occur. While we go to great effort to plan and prepare so that problems will be small and infrequent, problems will occur with every implementation. This should be emphasized in all communications so that everyone expects and is on the lookout for problems, and plans can be made to allow them to be dealt with. For example, in the video in Unit 1, Lecture B, the clinic decreased their patient load from several to one patient visit scheduled per hour for the first day of implementation. This decreased patient volume allowed clinic providers and staff the time to identify problems and time to work with implementation staff to troubleshoot and correct them. Problems occur in planning, communication, or the design of a new process, i.e., things were left out or not accounted for, or problems exist in the software itself. The important thing is not that problems occur, but that 1. Everything reasonable was done to plan and prepare to prevent problems, and 2. That problems are addressed swiftly. Take 5 minutes and review the example implementation plan for the automated appointment reminder system. List 2 possible problems that could occur in each of the following areas: planning, communication, the process, or in the software. We will review some common causes of problems on the next slide. Pause the slides now. When you have finished, restart the slides. Examples of possible problems include planning. Timeline didn't account for other activities, such as vacations of key people or activities were planned for during the workday that would have been better done during off hours. Forgot to include migration of legacy data to new system. Communication. Lack of communication to practice leadership. Lack of communication ahead of time with people. Lack of communication ahead of time with people involved in the plan. Process itself. Didn't take into account likely exceptions, such as, what about people who made appointments before the change? What happens if the system gets a voicemail? How does the system know it's the person? Forgetting to have a process for turning reminders off when appointments are moved. Software. Lack of testing. Found problems in testing and changes can't be made quickly enough. You may have noted other problems that are equally as valid. We mentioned evaluation as an implementation plan component. Process changes should be evaluated in some way to make sure that they had the intended impact. The evaluation should be a measure of achievement of the reason for change. In the simple example of implementation of an automatic appointment reminders system, the reason for the system and process change was a higher than desirable no-show rate. The metric for evaluating the change was decrease in the no-show rate. Because the new process impacted patients, a question about the reminder calls was added to the next cycle of the patient satisfaction survey. Some examples of things that can be measured to evaluate a process change include patient wait times, for example, from registration to seeing a provider, total visit time, percentage of same-day appointment accommodations, increased clinic capacity, higher number of encounters per day per provider, patient satisfaction measures, provider or staff time spent retrieving information, provider or staff time spent documenting, provider or staff satisfaction, and percentage of first-time file claims returned. The value gained from the evaluation must be weighed against the effort required to collect the data for the evaluation. Vendors should be questioned about data available for evaluation of planned process changes. In this unit, we covered common process changes, implementation plan components, communication for implementation, common implementation problems, and evaluating the new process. This concludes Unit 10, Process Change Implementation and Evaluation.